If sannyas is the ultimate lifestyle, why our ideals are in married form like Shiva Parvati, Krishna Radha, Rama Sita? Thank you, Perimani.
The whole question is absolute delusion based. If Paramashiva says sannyas is the ultimate life, look at Paramashiva as a sannyasi, Dakshinamurti. There are billions of sannyas ideal, Kapila, Adi Shankara, incarnations of Paramashiva as sannyasis. Look at all of them. If Paramashiva says married life is your life, then look at the married people, married incarnations as ideal. One, be very clear, neither Paramashiva and Parvati, Radha and Krishna, Rama and Sita are married like you. You are never going to have their kind of marriage. If you think you are going to have that, try. Your delusion tries to bring all the false justifications. Maybe suffering will teach you. Your delusion and false justification, false ideas attributed to the ideals. All these are delusion based questions, not the real seeking. Learn to have real seeking. Stop using the great incarnations to justify your lust. Your inability to do tyaga of lust should be directly dealt as your failure. Understand, it is just your failure. Stop with that. At least in some birth, in some janma, you will raise and decide to do tyaga. Do not use Radha and Krishna, Rama and Sita, Shiva and Parvati to hide your dirty failure. Learn to see the life as it is. Do not use any of them to justify your failure and your decision not to do tyaga. Your decision to live in delusion should not be justified, decorated with the great beings like Radha and Krishna, Rama and Sita, and Shiva and Parvati. If you get a person like Sita who will come with you to the forest, even though when you are married, you are a king, but suddenly you lost your kingdom, you are going to the forest, she is also ready to come with you, to live with you in the forest for 14 years. And even after being kidnapped by the great king Ravana, she decides to wait for you, not to go behind him. If you get a woman like Sita, please marry.